Sheinbaum, welcome. Could you please tell me the significance of this evening's banquet?
Well, in the first place, I'm going to do it by numbers. There are absolutely twice the number of people here that they expected. They even had to move to another room in the hotel. And the question is why. You have President Aristide here from Haiti, and he symbolizes something that's wrong about American foreign policy, where we do not support the man who was democratically elected, and we do what is convenient for supposedly American interests. Well, increasingly, Americans are bristling as human rights as a criterion, as a principle, increases in the minds of Americans. And this represents something of an outpouring of people who are not part of government, object to their own government, not supporting a man who was democratically elected. There's no reason why our foreign policy shouldn't stick to the principle. At this very moment, we're doing the same thing in Algiers. There was a democratic election there, and the military took over and threw out the democratic elected fundamentalist party.
Concretely, what more do you feel the U.S. government could be doing to help restore Aristide to power?
If the American government wanted to help, as it did, say, in 1953, to go back a long way, when the U.S. overthrew Mossadegh in Iran and put the Shah of Iran back in power. When the U.S. wants to do it, it can do it. It can find the ways to do it. It can fly them in there in a protected way and take care of it.
What is it about, specifically about President Aristide, that makes the U.S. so reluctant?
Well, there are attitudes within the U.S. government and the State Department these days. The Heritage Foundation, a very conservative think tank, seems to have a lot of influence on American foreign policy when it comes to Haiti. And this man has become a no-no for them. There's a limit to the amount of democracy U.S. will accept in those countries, because the people who are the democratic leaders are not always controllable by the Americans.